Welcome to another episode of Wellness Wednesdays, brought to you by Be Well Buzz. Today we're going to explore the science of reprogramming your DNA and the language of genes. The Western world made a set assumption, claiming only 10% of human genes are functional and important, but named the remaining 90% junk DNA. In fact, the seemingly useless DNA that scientists can scarcely explain make up not 90%, but actually 95 to 98% of genome, leaving us with around 2% useful DNA. Most scientists no longer consider this labeling to be valid. The human DNA isn't filled with junk, we just haven't been able to understand it. Recent study conducted through the Gene and Stem Cell Therapy Program at Sydney's Centenary Institute reported that at least part of the function of non-coding DNA, previously known as junk, is regulatory. Referred to as introns, these genetic materials don't contain code to build proteins, but control the expression of genes that do. Researchers observed that intron retention appears to be a biological means to control the activity of genes. They act as switches to turn genes on or off, or as the ensemble of the ENCODE project said, they may act like volume controls, turning a gene up or turning a gene down. ENCODE is an international project launched by the National Human Genome Research Institute in 2003. The purpose of this project is to identify all the functional elements within the human genome. The project has affirmed that 20,000 protein coding genes originally mapped out in 2000 are really just following orders. Yet, inside the previously named junk DNA, 10,000 new genes have been identified. Researchers believe that as much as 18% of our DNA sequence modulating less than 2% of our DNA. Finally, disproving the junk DNA theory, ENCODE has identified a biochemical function in 80% of DNA sequence. The ENCODE experts are enthusiastic that this greater understanding of genetic processes will lead to treatment for diseases, including heart disease, diabetes, and Crohn's disease, which are partly caused by genetic glitches. While the many hundreds of researchers from around the world joined forces together to study the human genome through the ENCODE project, researchers in Russia began their own adventure back in the 1990s. A team led by Dr. Pyotr Gerzhajev has been thinking down a different path. Rather than focus solely on physical material aspect of DNA, Gerzhajev examines also the subtle. He distinguishes between these two aspects as material substance and energy informational substance. Gerzhajev says that EI level and the primary level of existence. Thus, the once named junk DNA actually contains supercodes that function as superior level. Gerzhajev calls this the wave level. Gerzhajev has included a unique bunch of researchers in his efforts to understand DNA: biochemists, molecular biologists, embryologists, and even linguistic experts. Why linguistic experts, you might ask? Well, because live DNA speaks. High-level language is named because it's far more complex than, say, dancing bees or dogs barking. Human language is filled with variations and forms. It is now conceivable that languages were not a human invention. That is, they didn't come out of the air. We didn't originate language forms comprised of letters, phrases, and sentences. They were first patterned deep within us, swelling up and out of our mouth from our own DNA. Gerzhajev points out that our DNA employs all of the elements of complex language, which are alphabet, correct spelling, grammar, syntax, semantics, intent, or purpose. Furthermore, the coding contains homonyms, words that are spelled and pronounced the same, but whose meanings depend upon the context. This indicates that he calls a quasi-intelligence, namely that our DNA can make decisions, assessing the context of a code word in order to interpret the instruction. So if one word is changed or misunderstood, the instruction may be mutated and the gene will perform erratically. Michael Behe is the biochemist, professor, author, and intelligent design advocate. In his book Darwin's Black Box, Behe supports this idea that a genetic mutation is simple foul-up in communication. On one hand, this helps to explain genetic mutations that cause deformity and disease. On the other hand, the team in Russia believes it's the key to genetic reprogramming. In this case, a disease-mutated instruction might be avoided by superimposing the code of a healthy gene with the correct instruction. Spiritual teachers have known for ages that our body is programmable by language, words, and thoughts. And now numerous studies have been done and many articles written confirming that positive affirmations have power to reprogram DNA. To dig a little deeper, I recommend you check out the work of Dr. Bruce Lipton. Read his book, The Biology of Belief. Also check out Joe Dispenza and his book, Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself, How to Lose Your Mind and Create a New One. And also Greg Braden, who wrote The Divine Matrix. So choose your words wisely and always speak with love and care. Make sure to share this important information with family and friends by liking and sharing this video on Facebook. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel so I can let you know when our new videos are released. Be a part of a solution so together we can make the world a better place.